morning. I'm excited to welcome you all here today in recognition of these graduates and these white coat recipients. Will you all please stand? And gentlemen, remove your hats for our invocation, which is brought to us by Dr. Costin, University President.
Let's pray together. Merry Christmas, Lord. We thank you for giving us the opportunity to be in a personal relationship with you through Jesus Christ, your Son. And God, we have come today because there's about 70 or so young men and women who are about to receive the best Christmas present they've ever gotten. Half of them are going to receive a white coat, and they're going to go off and do clinicals. And a year from now, as you were true to your promise, we'll be back, and they'll be on the other side, where today the happiest bunch in this room will soon cross the stage, and they will graduate because of your providence, because of your grace, because of your mercy. And they will cross this stage to go and change the lives of other men and women who need a touch from you. They need a spiritual touch from you. They need a physical touch from you. They need emotional, relational healing. And you will use these graduates as your instrument to provide that healing touch to them as they graduate today, not as mere physician assistants, but as great physician assistants whom you have called to do great things. Father, as we pray today, we're thankful for the faculty and staff who poured themselves into these students even more than these students understand. We thank you for them because they would not be here today without the incredible, back-breaking work of this faculty and staff that really only you know all the work that they've accomplished. Father, I thank you for everyone in this audience today who is a family or a friend or otherwise supporter of one of these either graduates or white coat recipients today, because they have prayed hard, they have loved, they have encouraged, they have cajoled, and they have said on many occasions, you can do anything, but you can't quit. And so God, today we're grateful for them because this really does take a village. And we thank you, Father, that you have allowed us to be in this place today to celebrate their accomplishments, but also to celebrate you. And we pray, Father, as they go, that they would go for your glory and others' good. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
You may be seated. And gentlemen, you may return your hats to your heads. So thank you, Dr. Costin. On behalf of the faculty staff of Charleston Southern University, it's an honor to welcome each of you here to the commencement ceremony for the physician assistant class of 2022 and the white coat ceremony for the class of 2023. Several years ago, as our leadership team was planning for the future of Charleston Southern, they saw an opportunity to meet the need of our community for increased access to quality and affordable health care through the development of a PA program. The program was developed shortly thereafter with a mission to educate compassionate and highly motivated individuals through a curriculum integrated with Christian values to deliver patient-centered care as members of an interprofessional healthcare team, to serve as leaders in their communities, and to continually promote the PA profession. Today, we come together to celebrate these students who've successfully completed all of the requirements for graduation and to recognize the students in the class of 2023 who are prepared to continue their educational journey on clinical rotations. This is an exciting day, and the faculty, staff, and I are incredibly proud of each and every one of you. At this time, I'd like to introduce Dr. Scott Wade, Director of Didactic Education, to share about the significance of the white coat.
Thank you, Dr. Durr, Dr. Costin, Dr. Fish, Dr. Poole, distinguished guests, friends, family, students. Welcome to this moment that I know the students to my right have been waiting for the last 11 and a half months. We come today to celebrate the achievement of the white coat The white coat stands as a symbol. It initially started historically by healthcare providers to help fight infection. And over time, it became a symbol of trust, a symbol of value, a symbol of honor in the healthcare community, where those who wear the white coat are emburdened with the trust of a society to heal their needs physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. And it's my honor today to be able to present these coats to these students. These students have just completed a rigorous 12 months of classroom and laboratory studies with over 1,000 hours in lecture, structured learning, lab environment. They have worked diligently many day and night for the last 11 and a half months to get where they're at. The faculty and I have been blessed to watch them grow, not only in knowledge and skill, but as professionals, as the providers of healthcare that God has called them to be, blessing them with gifts of healing, ministry, and compassion. We have watched these students become professionals with Christ-like hearts. We've seen them struggle. I think we could say we've seen them stress a little bit. There's been laughter, there have been tears, and for some reason, a lot of clapping this year. I'm proud of the time and the effort, the hard work and dedication that these students have put into fulfilling their dreams. I've been blessed to be a part of their journey and look forward to their accomplishments and successes in the future. I look forward to seeing the impact that they will have on the world. Now I would like to ask Dr. Poole to come to the podium and present the candidates for white coat.
We will now begin the presentation of the short white coats. Will the first row of candidates please stand and move to the stage to receive your white coats? Please hold your applause until each student has received their white coat. Shannon Darby Altergott. Alexis Nicole Anderson. Margaret Mary Bailey. Taylor Lindsay Barnes. Alexander Jeffrey Beach. Lily Ann Betcher. Shatasia Samori Booker. Kendall Alexandra Bradford. Benjamin William Brewer. Caitlin Marie Brown. Corey Barbara Coleman. Kendall Ann Feeney. Connor Garrett Farino. Andrew Stephen Forino. Ashton Marie Giamona. Morgan Renee Hebert. Logan Elise Hilleman. Emma Teresa Jones. Madison Marie Crook. Nicholas Joseph Mello. Rebecca Manning Nelson. Carly Elizabeth Newman. Selena Del Carmen Nolte. Rosemary O'Shea O'Connor. Veronica Nikolaevna Olesyuk. Sarah Margaret O'Neill. J. Jack Andrew Payne. Holly Halden Petrusen. Eli Michael Robinson. Lily Pauline Sweeney. Skylar Margaret Tyndall. Jonathan William Venable. Sierra Shasta Wolf. Class of 2023, we congratulate you on your outstanding efforts in the first part of your journey to becoming a PA. You are an impressive group of individuals. We are so proud of each one of you, and we are excited to pray for you and support you as you embark on the next part of this journey. Please join me once again in congratulating the class of 2023. I would now like to invite Dr. Judy Hetz to the podium to introduce our guest speaker. Dr. Hetz is the chair of the Board of Trustees of Charleston Southern University.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. It is my privilege to introduce your guest speaker. When Gabby asked me, she did not know that I had been on the journey with Jackie since 2006 when she interviewed for the position. I was one of the trustees that was able to interview her. And then I was present when the first mention of starting a PA school here at Charleston Southern was mentioned. And then I also was there when Gabby received her position. So we've had a journey together, and I know the hard work that is going into starting this program and for you being here today. And so I just want to talk about Dr. Fish before she speaks. Dr. Fish began her career in 1978 as a police officer with the Knox County Sheriff's Department in Knoxville, Tennessee. From 1997 to 2006, Dr. Fish became a project manager and curriculum specialist with the Law Enforcement and Innovation Center at the University of Tennessee. During that time, she became the project manager for the creation and implementation of the National Forensic Academy at University of Tennessee. In 2004, she completed her doctoral degree in Instructional Technology, Curriculum, and Evaluation at the University of Tennessee. In 2006, Dr. Fish joined the faculty of CSU as a professor of criminal justice and director of the Criminal Justice Graduate Program. Dr. Fish was recognized as the outstanding alumni of Charleston Southern University through a faculty-wide nomination in 2012. The same year, she published a book featuring the work of her students, and that was a phenomenal achievement. Since 2012, Dr. Fish has served as Vice President for Academic Affairs at CSU. Under her leadership, the university has moved to a doctoral granting program, establishing a physician's assistant program, a doctoral degree in leadership, and a physical therapy program. This amazing accomplishment is that every one of the programs that she has led the charge on and applied for accreditation has been accepted. That is a renowned accomplishment. During her tenure as academic dean, the faculty of CSU has grown from 165 to 195. Enrollment in the CSU online and CAPS program has also increased. During the COVID pandemic, Jackie led the pandemic task force throughout the pandemic. She works directly with campus security to provide emergency training to faculty and staff on campus. Over her career, she has been co-author of 4 crime scene investigation textbooks. And I know she's more involved than what her resume says, because I was in the office last Wednesday and she told me that she'd been up from 1:30 to 3:30 teaching in Baghdad, right? So she's known internationally, not just at CSU. She was a project manager for anti-terrorism training programs for the United States Department of State. In the Low Country, Dr. Fish is a Red Cross trained volunteer and a community emergency response member. All I can say about Jackie's accomplishments is, wow, so much in a short term. What an incredible track record of accomplishments. Jackie, Charleston Southern was blessed the day that you entered the campus on 2006. And when she leaves and retires in May 2023, she is going to leave huge footprints for the next academic dean to follow. Today, I would like to welcome to the podium the person who led the charge for your program today and has it in place and running, Dr. Jacqueline Fish.
Those are all wonderful words, Judy. It's too bad Dr. Costin didn't know that. I might have got a pay raise somewhere. Thank you, Dr. Hetz, Dr. Costin, Dr. Poole, for inviting me here today to talk to the folks. I have to take just one moment, though, and introduce to you the President Emeritus, Dr. Jerry Hunter, who's sitting down here. Stand, please, Dr. Hunter. He is the impetus behind this program. To everyone in this audience, my utmost gratitude for your presence here today to celebrate this momentous occasion. I'm honored to stand before you as we are about to celebrate your success in the Charleston Southern University Physician Assistance Program. I'm very proud of the PA program and our dedicated staff and faculty and the accomplishments of the students. Most rewarding, however, and I think you'll experience this as well, is when you meet their graduates in their professional practice and they share just how much our PA program prepared them for the daily challenges they face. Just a personal statement, I wake up every morning listening to the song Amazing Grace. This is my way of starting off the day with positivity, and it reminds me of God's immeasurable love for each one of us. No matter what our circumstances, God has given us another day to live in His grace and continues to provide us with new opportunities to extend His grace and love to others. God's grace is available to us all the time for every problem and need we face. God's grace allows us to do good works and enables us to be all that God intends us to be. God's grace brought you to where you are today. It is amazing indeed. In Acts 15:11, we are reminded that as God's people, we believe it is through the grace of our Lord Jesus that we are saved. God's grace is an essential component for everyday life and foundational to our Christian faith. And we each one need God's grace every day to sustain us. We make mistakes all the time, but God's grace reassures us and reminds us that we are provided with an opportunity to glorify Him once more. Grace fills in the areas where we fall short, letting us know that everything will be okay. God's divine nature keeps us out of trouble, even if we listen to Him, if we will listen to Him and treat others with grace. Peter tells us, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. God's grace is present when we serve and we use the specific gifts that God has called us in all of our various responsibilities. As humans who fall short and will make mistakes daily, God invites us to be faithful stewards of God's grace. As we interact with others in our homes, our workplace, our ministry, or other social settings, we are to extend God's grace to others as God extends His grace to us. We are also to extend that grace to others in less than good circumstances. We are to extend grace to ourselves when our shortcomings take place and welcome those opportunities that we have for do-overs. The good news about God's grace is that it covers every scenario. I did become a little overwhelmed when I sat down to write this speech, but I felt God's blessings as I began to relive the creation of this CSU Physician's Assistant Program. We've made remarkable progress since CSU was granted permission a short few years ago, May of 2014, when we began to prepare for the ARC-PA accreditation. I'll tell you, that was my first foray into the world of physician assistant education as I traveled to St. Louis to attend mandatory ARC-PA training. And I will also tell you that I left there wondering what I'd gotten myself into, or what I'd let Dr. Hunter talk me into. By June 2015, we were working with an architectural team to develop the building plans, and less than a year later, we broke ground. I started counting the days. We only had a short 4 months to find a person willing to accept the challenge of building a physician's assistant program. And Dr. Gabby Poole was sent by God, I have no doubt, that's God's grace, to become the founding program director in September 16. Gabby and I became joined at the hip with our consultant, and we were able to design this program and complete the accreditation process that was due in January 17. So you see, these things are coming in four-month periods, and that's a short time to create a program, but God's grace allowed us to do that. During those next few months, we hosted a site visit in 2017, and we received our ARC-PA approval for provisional accreditation, so September 2017, and the inaugural class began in 2018. Yes, it was a whirlwind, but just look at where we are today. There are 86 successful physician assistants practicing in their profession who have graduated from this university. And now it's your turn. When this class walks out of here today, that's 120 professional physician assistants that we've put into the healthcare world. Employment for physician assistants is projected to grow 28% from 2021 to 2031. Much faster than the average for all other occupations. Physician assistants are trusted, they're rigorously educated, and they are trained healthcare professionals who focus on being patient-centered. PAs today are currently engaged in more than 500 million patient interactions each year in the United States. Being a PA is regularly ranked among the top three healthcare, STEM, and overall jobs. They blend their medical expertise and their compassionate care while increasing that access to healthcare for patients in every aspect of their lives. They provide that preventative care that leads to improved health outcomes and stronger communities. PAs are experts at making us, their patients, feel respected and confident as they have our best interests at heart. We get the attention and the treatment that we need with a little bit of God's grace sprinkled in there. These very dedicated people are absolutely due our most hearty congratulations today. Patients who receive their care from a physician assistant report a 93% satisfaction rate, and they certainly eliminate those two-hour wait in the doctor's office lobby. I know most of you have done that before. Much of that training is attributed to their patient-centered and highly rigorous medical training that they received here at CSU. So please accept my heartfelt appreciation for taking on the challenge of becoming professional healthcare providers. Today is your day to celebrate. And for the class of 2023, I know you're going to make us just as proud as you begin your clinical rotations in January. Stay strong, and remember that God's grace has brought you this far. And also, this time next year, you'll hear those magical words that our graduates heard the other day. Clean out your lockers, turn in your fobs, you don't need them anymore. I've got one personal observation. Everybody thinks that Disney is the happiest place on the planet. Well, I have news for you. Today, it's not Disney. It's right here in Lightsey Chapel with our class of 2022, with our class of 2023. Thank you so much for all you've done while you've been here at Charleston Southern. I know that your grace, you're going to be able to extend God's grace to all of those patients that you're taking care of. My final remark is a quote from Betsy Farrell. How far you go in life depends on you being tender with the young, compassionate with the aged, sympathetic with the striving, and tolerant of both the weak and strong, because someday you will have been all of these. So thank you again for the opportunity to come and speak to you today in the biggest day so far of your professional careers. Go with grace. God bless you and Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Dr. Fish, thank you so much for taking the time to be our commencement speaker and for that incredible message. When I asked you if you would be today's speaker, it was a strategic request. Not the type of strategy that aligns with the university's strategic planning process. None of us want that today. But instead strategic because it would create an opportunity for us to recognize you on this, your last official PA commencement and white coat ceremony. For those of you here today who do not know what you've been told already, the PA program is a direct result of the vision and leadership of Dr. Fish and our past president, Dr. Jerry Hunter, who is sitting on the front row, who we recognized earlier. Together with members of our campus community, they envisioned a program that would allow Charleston Southern to educate students in a Christian environment who would be able to go out into the communities in which they serve as medical providers to quite literally be the hands and feet of Jesus to their patients. Under the leadership of Dr. Fish, a needs assessment was completed that demonstrated that in many cases, PAs are the answer to increasing access to high quality and affordable health care for patients in this community and in communities across the country. With that information in hand, Dr. Fish began attending conferences. She just mentioned those, and ARC PA conferences are really grueling. To learn more about what it would look like to begin a PA program at Charleston Southern, and began building the infrastructure and allocating the resources that would be needed to do just that. The PA program at Charleston Southern is a direct result of Dr. Fish's leadership and vision, and as she finishes her very last fall semester as Vice President for Academic Affairs, the PA program wanted to be the first to celebrate and recognize her as she begins her official journey to retirement in May. Dr. Fish, you have been an incredible gift to this program. It would not be here without you. Ooh, I did not want to do this. But more importantly, you've been an incredible gift to me. It is not lost on me the tremendous opportunity you gave me to come to Charleston Southern, to be the founding PA program director, to be the person who would get to work alongside you to lay the foundation for this program so that we could do what we are doing today, celebrating 34 graduates and soon-to-be PAs and 33 students who are earning their short white coats and preparing to begin their clinical rotations. I know I did not deserve this opportunity, and I know that the decision to bring me to CSU was the result of a lot of prayer from you and Dr. Hunter, and I'm incredibly humbled and honored that I've gotten to work alongside you for the past 6.5 years. You are so much more than a boss. You are a mentor, a coach, and a friend. So today, the PA program faculty and staff and students would like to recognize you with an award. So this is the Outstanding Service Award. It's awarded to Dr. Jacqueline Fish for your loyal dedication and unwavering commitment to the Physician Assistant Program. Thank you for your leadership, which has afforded Charleston Southern University the opportunity to integrate faith into learning, leading, and service as we train the next generation of PAs. Much deserved. In addition to this award, we'd like to gift you your very own personalized stethoscope to recognize your commitment to our profession. You have most certainly earned it. So I'm going to give you that. Okay, I think we're Dr.
All right, so it's now my privilege to present the student awards. Our first award is the Watch Award and Scholarship, which was established by our medical director, Dr. Jamie Downs, and his family. This award recognizes a white coat student who has demonstrated a commitment to the medical profession by embodying the philosophy of the award: words, actions, thought, character, and habits. Today, we recognize Morgan Renee Hebert with the Watch Award and Scholarship. Please join me in congratulating Morgan. We now have three awards to present to the class of 2022, or students in the class of 2022. The first is the Excellence in Academics Award, which is presented to students who have earned the highest cumulative GPA at the completion of the program. These students have demonstrated outstanding academic achievement in the medical knowledge and skills needed to become a PA. We have four students who have earned this distinguished award. When I say your name, please come to the podium to receive your award. Nicole Ashburn.
Thank you.
Rebecca Blankenship. Jessica Lemire. And Johanna Shores. Congratulations, all of you, on this incredible academic achievement. Well done. So the next award is the Excellence in Leadership Award, which recognizes a graduating PA student who has had a significant and positive impact on advancing the mission of the CSU PA program and who demonstrates a commitment to PA education and the profession. The recipient of this award inspires and encourages personal and professional development in others and builds strong relationships that support a high level of trust and credibility. Faculty say this student is a humble leader who has demonstrated leading by example with honesty and integrity. This student has demonstrated a positive attitude throughout the program, approaching their work with passion, compassion, and humility. Today we recognize Josh Gerber with the Excellence in Leadership Award. The last award is the Excellence in Compassion Award, which recognizes a graduating PA student who has demonstrated community concern and exceptional compassion in medicine. The recipient of this award was selected by her classmates and excels in the art of relationship-centered and compassionate medical care and understands that in order to become a complete physician assistant, both science and compassion must be fostered. Classmates say this student consistently shows respect and kindness in all they do towards their classmates, faculty, and patients. They recognize this student's desire to help others and serve. Today we recognize Athena Velasquez with the Excellence in Compassion Award. Congratulations to all of our student award recipients and to those students who were inducted into the Pi Alpha Honor Society at yesterday's rehearsal for their significant academic achievement and for their leadership in research and community service and dedication to the profession. This year's inductees include Rebecca Blankenship, Josh Gerber, Caroline Huffman, Kathleen Faulkner, and Danny Juarez. So. And so now for our Preceptor of the Year Award. Each of our clinical year students is required to complete 9 rotations in different areas of medicine. A preceptor, who is a provider and a specialist in their field of medicine, volunteers their time and talents to invest in our students and leads them through each rotation. Preceptors continue seeing their demanding patient loads, yet take a student under their wing, teaching them everything they know in a condensed amount of time. The bond created between preceptor and student has the potential to be significant, transcending just the few weeks they spend together and lasting a lifetime. At the conclusion of the clinical year, graduates are asked to nominate a preceptor who had a significant impact on their clinical education. The preceptor must embody generosity, intentionality, and mentorship. The class of 2022 voted, and this year's preceptor of the year is Susan Cutter. Ms. Cutter is a critical care physician assistant with Roper Hospital and has been a preceptor for our program since the first clinical year in 2019. Sue was unable to attend today's ceremony, but we want to thank her for her commitment to our program and to our students. Thank you for pouring your heart and knowledge into our students and for being an outstanding example of a healthcare provider. I know she's watching, so I'm just going to say a few words about what the students had to say about her. Sue spends so much time advocating for her students. She introduces us to everyone at the hospital so they know who we are and can come grab us when something interesting is happening. She goes out of her way to make each new patient a teaching moment. She challenged me outside of my comfort zone and truly cares about her students and does everything she can to give us a great rotation experience. I never felt afraid to ask questions or ask for help, and I knew that I was always welcome to join in on anything that was going on. She kept me calm during stressful situations, which happen often in the ICU, and taught me a lot of skills I hadn't learned anywhere else. She is the true and shining example of the best preceptor, one who does everything to help her students learn and become better clinicians. Sue, this year would not have been possible without you. Thank you for your partnership, for investing in our students, and for leading by example. Please give a round of applause for Ms. Sue Cutter in recognition of her commitment. It's now my pleasure to introduce you to Josh Gerber, Student Leadership Association President for the class of 2022.
Thank you, Dr. Durr. Good morning. Again, my name is Josh Gerber, and I've had the privilege of serving as president for the class of 2022. First things first, I'd like to start with announcing our class gift. During our didactic year, many of the members of our class enjoyed the blissful climate of Charleston while studying in hammocks strung among the pine trees on campus. It became a regular occurrence to see clusters of hammocks as we studied and replenished our vitamin D. So much so that our morning updates with Dr. Kearns would include the daily hammock index. With that being said, the class of 2022 is proud to donate an Eno Pod three-person hammock stand with hammocks for the future classes to enjoy. To the class of 2023, I want to wish you congratulations. You finished the first leg of your journey and are prepared to enter clinics, hospitals, and operating rooms. Be confident in your knowledge, yet humble in your attitudes. I am certain that you will make CSU proud. To the faculty and staff of CSU, thank you for your endless dedication to your students. You have all gone above and beyond to prepare us to enter the workforce as clinicians. We have been blessed to have been mentored by such knowledgeable, caring, and godly individuals, and look forward to continuing our relationships as colleagues. To our friends and families, thank you for all of your unending support. PA school has demanded the greater portion of our attention and focus, and at times we may have neglected our relationships, but you stood by us and supported us. We would not be here today without you. Thank you. Finally, to the class of 2022, we made it. We formed deep bonds through the tribulations of PA school, and I hope these friendships span a lifetime. It has been an unforgettable experience to watch you all grow as professionals and prove that you are up to the challenge of PA school. For 2 years, you have proven a level of intelligence, persistence, and professionalism that makes me proud to call you my friends and colleagues. We have been given the great gift of knowledge, and there will come a time for us to repay that gift. We would not be sitting here today if it were not for our faculty and staff and preceptors. Whether you stay in Charleston or spread across the country, I have one challenge for you. Once you've established yourself in your career, I challenge you to turn around and give back. Precept students, give guest lectures, and pour into the lives of future clinicians. Return on the great gift that we've received. Congratulations, class of 2022, and God bless.
Dr. Fish and Dr. Costin, if you will join me at the podium to begin the conferring of degrees.
Will the candidates for the Master of Medical Science degree please stand? These students have completed graduate degrees in physician assistant studies. Mr. President, the candidates who stand before you have met all of the requirements for the degree of Master of Medical Science in Physician Assistant Studies and are recommended by the faculty to receive this degree.
By the authority vested in me by the Lord God Almighty and by the State of South Carolina, and the Board of Trustees at Charleston Southern University, and by the Board delegating that authority to me, I confer upon each of you the degree Master of Medical Science in Physician Assistant Studies, with all rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Please come forward to receive your degrees as your name is called. Again, I would ask you to please hold your applause until each student has received their degree. Austin Howard Akins. Chelsea Marie Alfonso. Nicole Catherine Ashburn. Tabor Renee Beta. Taryn Nicole Bentler. Rebecca Ann Blankenship. Emma Lauren Butler. Amy Yao Chang. Megan Madison Dixon. Kathleen Starling Faulkner. Joshua Ernst Gerber. Victoria Elizabeth Harrington. Gary Andrew Hensey. Caroline Marie Huffman. Daniel George Juarez. Jordan Michelle Kramer. Clara Younghae Lee Kwan. Shelby Jane Ladd. Jessica Melina Lemire. Evelina Mariana Luchik. Johanna May Shores. Stephen Smith. Paige Elizabeth Song. Athena Manie Velasquez Glover. Bianca Nima Wibziano. Class of 2022, please stand. You may switch over your tassels. And audience, please join me in congratulating the class of 2022. We are so proud of y'all. You may be seated. And it is now my honor to introduce Dr. Jamie Downs, medical director of the program, who will lead all of our students in the physician assistant oath.
Thank you. I would ask our graduates and white coat recipients, please rise. This physician assistant oath is a list of tenets for PAs to live by in their professional lives and puts the health, safety, and privacy of their future patients first. By taking this oath, they also agree to adhere to the professional code of ethics established by the American Academy of Physician Assistants, which includes four main bioethical principles: patient autonomy, beneficence, non-maleficence, and justice. PAs are expected to behave both legally and morally, and our hope is that when faced with an ethical dilemma, they will reflect on this oath and professional code of ethics for guidance. Please repeat after me. I pledge to perform the following duties with honesty and dedication. I will hold as my primary responsibility the health, safety, welfare, and dignity of all human beings. I will uphold the tenets of patient autonomy, beneficence, non-maleficence, and justice. I will recognize and promote the value of diversity. I will treat equally all persons who seek my care. I will hold in confidence the information shared in the course of practicing medicine. I will assess my personal capabilities and limitations, striving always to improve my medical practice. I will actively seek to expand my knowledge and skills, keeping abreast of advances in medicine. I will work with other members of the healthcare team to provide compassionate and effective care of patients. I will use my knowledge and experience to contribute to an improved community. I will respect my professional relationship with the physician. I will share and expand knowledge within the profession. These duties are pledged with sincerity and upon my honor. Thank you. You may be seated. I'd like to call Dr. Durr back up to the lectern.
Well, Class of 2022, congratulations. The faculty, staff, and I are extremely proud of each and every one of you. Class of 2023, I hope this excites you for everything you have to look forward to over the next year. Please know that we'll continue to support you and guide you through this journey and look forward to celebrating all of your accomplishments next year. As we close, I would like to thank Dr. Poole, Dr. Costin, and Dr. Fish for their continued leadership and support of this program and university. I would also like to take a moment to recognize the faculty and staff who have worked exceptionally hard to ensure the success of this program and to guide and to mentor these students along their academic journeys. To show our appreciation for each of the students and you, their guests, we have a light reception outside of the chapel. As a reminder, the Health Science Building will remain open until 1 p.m. if you would like to spend some time over there as well. As we close, I would like to pray Jeremiah 29:11 over each of you. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. Go out and do good, graduates, abiding in the hope and promise we have in Christ. Please stand for the recessional.